I love the colorful clothes she wears and the way the sunlight plays upon her hair.
Billy Taitingfong, and I'm a paddler with the Guam national team. And in preparation for Pacific Games in New Caledonia, we took it amongst ourselves to paddle in the various water conditions of Guam. And so in one instance, we decided to paddle in Apra Harbor and circle around the harbor. And apparently we crossed this imaginary line because Coast Guard boats sped up to us, warning us that we must turn around and go back to where we came from. For me, I felt a little disrespected because as Guam's national sport, you think we would have more leeway in paddling in the waters and not being restricted by the military.
I love snorkeling. I mean, that's one of my passions, I guess, in life. I mean, I used to, when I was younger, spend a lot of time just at beaches. So I, in general, love being at the beach.
Well, on Guam, I mean, I've had opportunities to snorkel at some of, I think, the best places on Guam. But I think, personally, the best place on Guam to snorkel is Gab Gab, which is a naval station, Big Navy. The variety of fish and the corals are,
of course,
really,
it's very hard to get on base and especially since 9/11, access has gotten even harder. Spanish Steps was mind-blowing, but that is extremely restricted. I mean, you can get permission to go on base, but you can't just go to Spanish Steps. You have to have sort of special permission to go there, so that is an extremely regulated site. Now, before 9/11, you could actually go on to Naval Station. You could get a pass without a sponsor. If you were going to a historic site, but that's no longer possible. It's, you know, it's quite difficult. And I mean, you know, you don't want to just always be asking friends to help you do this just so you can go snorkeling. So, yeah, I mean, I think it's a shame because what's happened, you know, is that especially in my adult years, as I've been able to go on to some of the bases through friends, is I've realized that some of the most beautiful places in Guam are behind bases.
It's
spectacular. And it's the kind of beach that I think most people on Guam have no idea exists on Guam. You know, it's pretty accessible if you're on base. It's unfortunate, I think, that more people don't have access and locals, because most people, you know, live and die on Guam and don't realize how much of the island's beauty is even exists. They just don't know, right? They've never seen it, never been there, and will never go there.
There could be things done to open up access to locals.
For example, when I was living in Hawaii, I was pretty surprised when I found out that one of the most popular beaches for boogie boarding, Bellows, was actually on military property, but the military allows people to come and use it on weekends. So, you know, something like that. I mean, to go to Tarangi Beach, to go to Gab Gab, you know, there would be ways to open access without, you know, compromising the safety of the nation. It's just letting people go swimming and snorkeling.
Fishing has been a long-standing tradition for the people of Guam. The first people to arrive in Guam at least 3,500 years ago were skilled fishermen. And ever since, each generation has been taught the importance fishing has for their culture and survival. The indigenous fishing community has demonstrated resiliency in the face of natural perturbations such as typhoons, droughts, and the effects of mankind. However, due to the military buildup, many shore and deep sea areas have become inaccessible due to military restrictions. This has caused many intense reactions within the local fishing community.